Hey guys, we are back with some more Czeching Lions franchise mode, and in this one, we are going to start year number two, but first, have a couple things to go over. I did change the line since the last one. Not too much, but a little bit. I have now Aronson in the middle, because if you remember correctly, Wenberg's face-offs weren't great last year in the simulation, only 46%. So I'm going to try Aronson in the middle, see if he's capable of taking face-offs, so that way we can retain the +3 on the first line as well as the +5 on the second line. Now, something else I noticed, if we put Richie on the second line, it also gives you a +5. So we do have a couple options there, but I want to stick with Janssen, Namestnikov, and Duclair, because Janssen is the higher overall than Richie, so I figured maybe he'll give more of a boost to Namestnikov and Duclair. And something else that I wanted to do, I wanted to give a spotlight specifically to this guy, Derek Bentley, the enforcer that we drafted in the fourth round this past draft. Something I didn't notice about him when drafting him, his offensive awareness is up there at a 78, which that's honestly pretty impressive for an enforcer. And his speed's already up there at 83. I don't mean to say he's going to be great yet or anything, because clearly he's only a 67 overall. We don't know for sure. But if he grows the right way, he may very well end up being very good for us, because honestly, his offensive awareness as a defenseman is better than his defensive awareness. I don't think I've seen a defenseman like that, an enforcer specifically like this, in this game. So I'm very interested to see how he grows, because his offensive awareness is only 2 less than Ralph Stillman's. He's currently at an 80 for offensive awareness, so it's going to be very interesting to see how he goes. He's 6'7", by the way. He's going to be a train on the back end if he makes the NHL. Oof, can't wait. And Ralph Stillman, 6'5", 2 behemoths on the back end. So I definitely want to keep an eye on specifically Bentley, but we'll keep an eye on Stillman as well, because, you know, he's going to be, without a doubt, our stud defenseman of the future. But with that being said, I think that's about it as far as things that we need to do before preseason starts, because I'm fine with this roster as it is. Well, I mean, obviously, I don't think we'll rack up too many wins with this roster. I think this is going to be another losing season, because after what we saw last season, it's likely not going to happen anytime soon. So we may as well just use this season to grow guys like Aronson and hope that guys on our second line like Janssen, Domestikov, and Duclair get a lot better from that +5. Now, we did have a similar situation on the first line last year with a +5. And it didn't work out too well. But hopefully it's different for Janssen, Namestnikov, and Duclair. So just thought I'd point out, Aronson on faceoffs in the preseason was a 42%. So I think I'm going to switch him back to the wing for the start of the season. We'll put Wenberg in the middle instead, because obviously Wenberg is the older player, the more experienced player. So maybe he can get himself to a 50% by chance. So we're going to put Wenberg in the middle there. Hopefully he can come through with the face-off percentages. I mean, even if he doesn't manage to get 50, it's better than the 42 that Aronson showed in the preseason. But other than that, that is the only change I want to make going into the regular season. Here we go. Devin Aronson's first NHL game up against the Columbus Blue Jackets. We're going to go into the game and see what happens here. First period, nothing doing. Second period, goal for Martinuk on Demko. Third period, if we slow it down and we go in late in the third period, just see what happens. Maybe, who knows, maybe we get to see his first goal in live action. Presuming, of course, that the game wants to stop the simulation when I actually tell it to. There's a goal for Janssen on the power play. We are tied at 1. We're dominating in shots. Wenberg with a goal as well on his old team. First of the season for him. And there it is, Aronson with his first goal in his first game. How do you like that? Janssen with another goal. We exploded in this third period. I guess there's no need to go into it now since Aronson already has his first goal. But still, nonetheless, Janssen with a hat trick. Wow. What a third period for your Czeching Lions. 3 stars of the game. Janssen, Wenberg, and the rookie Aronson in his first game with a goal, an assist, and 2 hits. So we just had our first major injury of the year. Thatcher Demko goes down till January 21st. I didn't see with what, but he had a pretty major injury there, so we're going to have to call up Brassois, and I guess Kincaid's going to be the starter for right now, because I believe that is, at the very least, a month-long injury, possibly longer, as I believe we are only in November, so actually, that'd be like 2 months. Yeah, that is a 2-month injury for our goaltender, Thatcher Demko. That is unfortunate. So let's just go to the end of November here, and then we'll have an update. On November 30th now, we are currently 14-9, better than I expected, but I'm not surprised, honestly, because we do have that +5 second line, and it looks like Anthony Duclair is absolutely tearing it up. 15 goals and 13 assists in 23 games played. He was a phenomenal signing, and we have him for 3 years as well on a $4 million deal. If he grows from this kind of season to be, let's say, an 87 overall just by chance, then that's a bargain for the next 3 years or so. It really is, if we're able to maintain this +5. Nemestikov with 6 goals and 17 assists, and Janssen with 8 goals and 13 assists. So that entire second line doing what I was expecting the first line of last year to do. So we're finally seeing the chemistry at work here. We're keeping that line together all year. You betcha. Devin Aronson doing very well for himself in his rookie season. 12 goals to start out in 23 games played. And 8 assists as well. +3 on the season so far. 20 points in total. 36 hits, so he's a hitter as well. He's pretty solid all around so far this year. I couldn't really ask for much more out of him, at least to start out. He's got a game winner. 76 shots, so he takes a lot of shots. I'm liking what I'm seeing out of Devin Aronson. I think we have to give a lot of credit to Alex Wennberg here, though. 22 assists in 23 games played on that line, and 4 goals as well. So he's certainly pulling his weight more than I expected him to. Faceoff percentage almost at a 49, so I'm all right with that. Not much of a hitter, but I guess Devin Aronson makes up for that, as well as he's the fact that he is a takeaway specialist, it looks like. 33-9 currently is his takeaway to giveaway ratio. So Alex Wennberg here has thrived on the first line so far. Nick Ritchie, a bit underwhelming once again with 5 goals and 7 assists. But I guess that first line is working, so I'm not inclined to take him off at the moment. But I would like to see a bit more out of Ritchie, especially since he's currently being outperformed by the rookie Aronson, you know. As for the team stats, we are currently sitting second in our division with 3.61 goals for per game. So we are scoring quite a lot. However, our goals against per game is also up there at a 3.13, second most in the division, which in this case is not good. Power play is first in our division, 23.9. So our power play is, well, it's good to know that it's working. And the penalty kill, middle of the road, 82.3. We're doing better than I expected, so I can't really complain too much. Honestly, as long as we get a good pick with the St. Louis pick, because remember, we do have St. Louis's pick, and it does look like they're not having the greatest season so far, 10-11-3. So prospects update, we're seeing some really good growth out of Derek Bentley. +2 to everything in puck skills so far, +1 to offensive awareness, which means that it's now a 79. And not only that, but in 23 games, he already has 9 points in the US League, +13 as well. So, Derek Bentley, I'm telling you, watch out for him. He's looking like he could be a pretty good one. So, we're on January 1st now, and Devin Aronson having a heck of a rookie season. 19 goals and 16 assists in 37 games played for 35 points. Third in our team for scoring currently. And he also, I believe, has the most shots. Yes, he does. So, looks like we got a good one. Looks like we got a good one in Devin Aronson. If he could just get his takeaways and giveaways up there, like double his takeaways than what he has for giveaways, he'd be golden. And you know what? Credit to Kincaid. He's gotten us through these past couple months while Demko's been down for an injury. And even when Demko was playing, it doesn't look like he was too good. 895, unfortunately. So, credit where it's due. Kincaid's certainly pulling his weight. So I just checked on Derek Bentley's growth again. He's already a 71 overall. He started as a 67, I believe. I'm telling you, he's going to be something special. Look at his puck skills growth. 5 for every category. 3 for offensive awareness. He's already up to an 81 offensive awareness as an enforcer, defenseman. +3 to defensive awareness, shot blocking, and stick checking. +2 to endurance. +3 to most categories in the physical category. And he can't get plus anything to fighting skill because he already has a 99 for fighting skill. I'm telling you, watch out for Derek Bentley. He is looking fantastic. So, more good news. The Blues Look at the Blues. They've fallen off 25, 31 and 6, 56 points. I don't think they're making the playoffs. I really don't think they're making the playoffs at this point. So it looks like we have a lottery pick with the Blues pick. And then we, of course, have our pick. But difference is we're in the playoffs currently. 34, 22 and 6, 74 points on the season, third in our division. And it doesn't look like we're going to be falling out anytime soon as long as we have, you know, keep going on the pace that we've been going on. And even more good news, Devin Aronson, the rookie, currently leads our team in points with 64 points in 62 games, 36 goals, on pace for at least a 40-goal season, if not 45, I would say, more like, and in only 202 shots as well. 17.8 shooting percentage. That is insane. And not only that, but he's also up to an 84 overall. So we've seen some in-season growth from Aronson. And we're in the playoffs. We got St. Louis's pick. Things are looking good. Okay, I know this is the third time this video. But Bentley is going to be insane, I'm telling you. 75 overall already. Look at his puck skills, how they've developed. 86 for hand-eye, 81 for deking as an enforcer defenseman, and plus 7 to passing and puck control, plus 6 to offensive awareness, 84 offensive awareness already. He's going to be insane. I just have this gut feeling he is going to be insane. Like, he literally matches Ralph Stillman's overall already. What a draft pick. What a draft pick so far he is turning out to be. I don't think there's any moves that I want to make going into the trade deadline. I don't feel like I need to be honest, because all the players that we have, I feel comfortable moving forward into the future with, especially that plus 5 second line. I feel like we have to hold on to these guys just to see, even if to see how much they grow. And obviously, we're not getting rid of Aronson for anything. Wennberg, he's done very well so far. Actually, incredible so far compared to what I had expectations for him. 54 assists in 62 games. Definitely have to keep him. Richie, I guess, could be expendable at some point, but he's part of that first line that's helping Wennberg and Aronson do so well, so I'm not inclined to take him off. And the team's just working right now. I don't know. I'm not sure what else to say, because it just works. So you may as well just give this roster the chance to go all out and win the Stanley Cup. And again, while we're at it, the Blues not looking too good. So with that being said, I think we're just going to advance through the rest of the season here. So here we are at the end of the regular season. And we made the playoffs. We indeed did make the playoffs just 1 year after the horrible finish that we had last year. We finished 46, 30, and 6. Good for 98 points on the season. And where did the Blues finish? 79 points. What does that leave them in the league standings? I want to see what our odds are at that first overall pick. Let's see. So they're 28th in the league. That is, if I'm not mistaken, that is no worse than 8th overall. For that pick, that's not bad. Not bad at all. Getting into the player stats here, you got Alexander Wennberg leading the team with 79 points, 69 assists on the season. And Devin Aronson, the rookie, 44 goals on his rookie campaign. He is insane. 268 shots, 25 power play points, 18 of them being goals. Wow, is all I have to say for a first season of Devin Aronson. 121 hits, so he's a hitter. He looks to be at least okay with his giveaway and takeaway ratio. I'm really liking what I'm seeing out of Devin Aronson so far. Anthony Duclair, pretty good season. 72 points, you know, only 82 overall. He's on the second line, but he's playing more like a first liner, in my opinion. So, hey, you know what? I will take it. Hopefully that continues in the playoffs. Namestnikov with 69 points, 63 for Janssen. So a lot of depth scoring here. Richie with 56, Shea with 48 points. I was not expecting that. How did he do last year? He only had 22 points last year, so 48. Quite the improvement. Hintz with 45, Zajac with 40. So we really got some depth scoring here. And he hardly even had power play time. That's 39 even strength points. Well, unless, yeah, there's three of them shorthanded, but still, that's 36 even strength points for Travis Zajac. Good offensive simulation this year. Teddy Bluger with 34. 34 for Hartman as well. 27 for Donato. 22 for Lievo and Foote. 19 for Larson. 13 for TVR. 11 for McCabe. 11 for Gunnarsson. 7 for Okposo in 5 games. So nice veteran depth there, I suppose. 7 for Lucic in 9 games, so once again, veteran depth coming in clutch, and 1 for Brad Hunt in 2 games. And now in goal, this is kind of interesting. So Demko with a 905 in 44 games, and a 906 for Kincaid in 34. So I guess the question is, who do we go to in the playoffs? I would like to think it's Demko, just because he has the potential and the overall, but Kincaid, you could argue, is just as deserving. I don't know. Honestly, I don't know. They both got the same amount of wins. Demko had an assist. There's not much separation between them, honestly. Just for record, we're going to check the progress reports, because I want to see how much growth our prospect in Bentley got. Okay, so he stayed at 75, but his puck skills all up by 8. Offensive awareness stayed up by 6, so he's at an 84. His shot didn't improve too much, but that's okay, because, I mean, everything else is seemingly skyrocketed. Defensive awareness is up to a 79. That started at a 73. Yep, Derek Bentley looking pretty good, and that's not even including the offseason jump that he might get as well, so keep an eye out for Bentley. He's looking insane so far. Lambos with 66 overall. McCutcheon's is 65 now. I believe he started at 59. And then Stillman did not appear to have much growth, but hopefully he'll see some over the offseason. So I spent all that time looking at Bentley, but I got to give credit to Uriel Doherty as well. He was at 48 overall to start this season. He is now at 64 as that low top four defenseman that we drafted. When did we draft him? In the 6th round. So he's looking pretty promising so far, at least. Plus 9 to all of his puck skills, plus 11 to offensive awareness. Yeah, looking very solid is Uriel Doherty, at least compared to when we drafted him this past year. So I give him credit. That's a lot of growth. So unfortunately, the Paladins just missed the playoffs. They finished the season 42-32-8. And unfortunately, they will not be participating in the playoffs this year. But the good news is that we will be. So I guess we'll leave it off there. In the next one, we will be facing the Boston Bruins. They are 52-26-4 on the season. So let's check out their lines. First line, Marchand, Bergeron, Pastrnak. Yeah, nothing more to be said there. Second line, DeBrusque, Krejci, and Kasha. Third line, Bjork, Coyle, and Smith. Fourth line, Corrali, Studnicka, and Johan Larsson. On defense, you have McAvoy and Ristolainen, Vlasic and Stetcher, Vakanainen and Carlo. So looking a bit different on defense there is Boston with Vlasic and Stetcher and Ristolainen as well. So a few new additions there to the back end. And then in goal, you have Jordan Binnington along with Jaroslav Halak. So once again, quite a different Bruins squad, or at least on defense and in goal. But nonetheless, not a team that I am looking forward to going up against. Once again, I'll end it off here. Let me know what you guys think. And I will see you guys in the next one when we face the Boston Bruins in our first ever playoff series. See you guys then.